I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making lime mist gelatin salad. And this is the kind of salad that if you're going to have it for dinner in the evening, you're going to have to start very early in the morning making it. But even better, if you'll just start it the night before, it'll have overnight to do its thing, and you'll finish it up the next day. That would be the best approach. What I have is some applesauce in a saucepan. Here's the applesauce. You can see some is still left in this container because what I needed was 2.5 cups. That's 20 ounces, and this was a 25-ounce jar. So you might be able to find it in a can that's exactly 20 ounces. But that applesauce, you heat on the stove. So I've just come from the stove with this, and it's actually got steam coming up off it. I didn't let it bubble. I didn't let it boil, but it is hot. To this applesauce, I'm going to be adding some gelatin. And what I have is lime flavor, JELL-O. And I've chosen the sugar-free. I'm trying to make this as light as possible. Some of you have requested things that have just a few calories in it and are healthy. But you can adapt this. You can make it with the regular JELL-O. Just anytime I say fat-free or sugar-free, just do whatever you want to do with your recipe. This is just a small pack of lime flavor JELL-O. And I'm sprinkling that in to the hot applesauce. And then I want to stir it around. One thing I'm going to add to this is some diet lemon lime soda, 7-Up if you want to use that. You need 1 cup, which is 8 ounces worth. Put that right in here because that gelatin is going to need some liquid in order to work properly, and the applesauce is not enough. So stir this together, and then this is going to need to sit all night or maybe during the day for 8 hours or so to gel up. And it's not going to be a hard gel, it's going to be kind of softly gelled. But I want it to look pretty, so I'm going to go ahead and choose my serving bowl. I have a glass bowl here, and I'm just going to pour this in. We have our lime JELL-O mixed with our applesauce and our lemon lime soda. What will happen with this is I will take some plastic wrap and cover that and put it in the refrigerator for at least 8 hours. Now the other mixture I'm working with, I'm going to take some fat-free cream cheese. I need 3 ounces worth. This is an 8-ounce pack. Here are the other 5 ounces. I took off 3 ounces. And you can see it's chopped up a bit, kind of in small pieces, so it will be manageable for me when I get ready to do some more work on this later. To this, I'm going to add 2 cups of miniature marshmallows. One more thing goes in here, and that is whipping cream. So I have just ultra-pasteurized whipping cream. I pour that in, and that makes this into a nice blend that I will stir around. I want to get those marshmallows submerged a bit. And then I'm basically through with what I can do at this point. So what's going to happen with this one is you'll notice I've put it in a mixing bowl. Later it's going to get mixed with an electric mixer. So choose an appropriate bowl to put this in. So we put our applesauce JELL-O mixture in a nice fancy bowl. We put our marshmallow cream cheese whipping cream mixture in a mixing bowl. And then we'll cover the top of both of them with plastic wrap and just wait for 8 hours or overnight until we can finish them up. It's been several hours since I put these two bowls in my refrigerator, and I have just gotten them out, and I want to show you what the lime mist salad is beginning to look like. It should be gelled to this point. You see, I'm not worried about messing up the top because I'm going to be putting something over it. I just want you to see that it's a very light gel. It's not really hard because there's that applesauce.
So if this mixture has gelled to the point that you're satisfied with, then that means your mixture of marshmallows, cream cheese, and whipping cream will be ready for you to whip. And it's nice if you have chill blades for your mixer. So I stuck these in the freezer for just a minute. And now I'm gonna start beating these until we have a nice beaten topping. It's gonna make some noise, so I'll go away and you'll see the finished result. So my whipped cream mixture has been beaten. And you'll notice that it's a little bit lumpy because there's a little bit of a marshmallow here and there, but that's kind of nice. I like to leave it like that. I don't want to overbeat it. So all I want is a nice topping for my salad. I'm coming over to this Lime Mist salad and I'm going to spoon out the topping, and I can feel pretty free to spread it because it's gelled to the point where it's not going to mix in. And when you're satisfied with the look of the top, which doesn't have to be anything in particular, you just basically want pretty much full coverage of the top. But if a little green peeks through, that's kind of nice because it will contrast with what we're going to put on it. Okay, let's stop right there. And then what I'm going to put on it are a couple of things. I'm going to use some chopped pecans. These are called fancy pecan pieces. Just any kind of chopped pecans that you might have. Just take your hand and grab a bunch and sprinkle those so it will look appealing. This is for garnish and a little bit of flavor too. I'd say that I got maybe a quarter of a cup and that should be fine. You don't want to junk it up with a lot of stuff. There's only one other topping that I have here, and this looks kind of bloody, but it's really maraschino cherries that I have sliced, and I've sliced them on top of a paper towel because they will bleed and I don't want them to bleed into the salad. Now there were 7 in this jar, so I'm using 7. There's no particular rule on that. It's just that's what I had in my refrigerated jar, and I've chopped them into fourths. I did half of the maraschino cherry and then each half I halved again. That gives some smallish pieces, and this juice will go back in the refrigerator, as you know, for cherry cokes and for making cherry flavored whipped topping, things of that sort. Doesn't get wasted, but our little garnish here will look really pretty because you just take your hand and sprinkle these about. And you would be overpowering it, really, if you used whole maraschino cherries. So you just want little bits here and there. Let me speed this up a little bit. You want them separated out somewhat, not big clumps. That's why I would take the time to do it by hand. And it's beginning to shape up, and you have your lime mist salad. And it has its garnish on top with your chopped nuts and your chopped maraschino cherries, which are not bleeding all over the place. So what I'm going to do now is cover this back with plastic wrap, and it will go back in the refrigerator, and it will stay there until we get ready to serve dinner. We're having a nice pot roast for dinner. We're going to have some fresh herb bread. And this will complement that dinner really in a good way. So I'm going to protect it with the plastic wrap, and it'll just be waiting for us at dinner time.